Hey guys, welcome to Ask an Electrical Engineer, the series where all of the non-engineers like to come up with a series of questions, make sure that I have no idea what they are, and then put all this engineering stuff around me, mostly to embarrass me. I think that's what the point is. So, today's topic is LEDs, and you're gonna learn more about LEDs than you will from any other source, guaranteed. First question. How do LEDs, light emitting diodes, work? And what's a diode? That's two questions, guys. Two. First of all, what's a diode? So a diode is something, electricity goes one way and doesn't go another way. That's really all you need to know. You don't even need to know that for understanding how an LED works. If you want to get a little bit more complicated, it's because you get these two materials together and the way the energy of electrons works, you put a voltage one way and they're like, whee, and they go where they're supposed to, but you put the voltage the other way and it's kind of like making it so they're trying to climb up a hill and just doesn't really work. So that's how a diode works on a more fundamental level, but in reality, all you need to know, diodes, electricity goes one way, and the other way it's like, ugh, can't quite make it. Now what does this have to do with light emitting diodes? Only thing that it has to do with light emitting diodes is that LEDs are diodes. So, like I said, two materials come together. So LEDs, and how they work in particular, is they get that material so that when an electron is going from one to the other, it drops in just the right amount of energy that it emits a photon. So basically you can kind of think of it as something stepping off a curb, and as it jumps off a curb, it loses a certain amount of energy, and we can control how much of a drop it is, and therefore how much energy it is to give us the photon. So you want to drop more energy, you get a bigger gap, and then you get something like an ultraviolet LED. You want less energy, where you're like in the infrared or red, and you have a smaller step down, and then as that electron goes, bloop, and it drops in the energy, that energy is released as light instead of heat, which is what happens in a normal diode. Next question. Why are LEDs better? Wow, okay, talk about wide scope in questions. Why are LEDs better? Big thing, they're very efficient, much better than incandescents. Man, I could ramble on this all day long, and if you want, I think I've done another video where I did exactly that. They're more efficient, they're tough, they can flicker on and off really good, so they're good for communications, they're good for dimming in a really power efficient way. Did I mention they're tough? I just love the fact that you can take them and throw them around. Do I have an LED around here? Nope, that was an oversight. But they're cooler to the touch. You can actually touch them without burning yourself, whereas incandescents, I want you to see how long you can keep your finger on even the lowest power incandescent bulb and tell me how that feels. You can get all sorts of cool colors, and I mean, they're just cool. If you want a better response, I got like 15 plus minutes about it on some other video, so knock yourself out. When did LEDs become popular? What? Okay. When did LEDs become popular? They were invented like in the 1950s or something, but they were super expensive and not super bright. And then they figured out, oh, hey, we can make these a lot cheaper and a lot brighter in like the 70s. And that's when those red LEDs came out. And as I mentioned earlier, red LEDs, there's smaller drop in energy. So those were the first ones that came out and they were super popular. Instead of being like 20, 30 bucks, they dropped down to a couple cents per LED. And so that's when they started getting into the mainstream of everything. Now, LEDs that you get all over the place, that became popular when the blue LEDs came out. So as the energy level stepped up, you got red LEDs, you got green LEDs, and then finally with blue LEDs, you can mix RGB to get white. Even a colorblind guy like me knows that that's how you get white. So the blue LEDs came out, those were early 90s is when they figured that out, and they didn't become super mainstream and super popular until like 2000 on. And I mean, they're just getting more and more popular. So when did LEDs become more popular? Maybe the right answer to that is now. They're just getting all over the place. They're getting so cheap. They're getting so efficient that, I mean, it's getting ridiculous. Next question. How much more efficient are LEDs than other options? Let's compare them to obvious incandescent halogen. Way more efficient. 5-6 times, and that's at current levels. It can get even more than that, I imagine, in the future. And that's to the latest, most efficient incandescent that they've been working on trying to make those more efficient for 100 years. So compared to the original Thomas Edison one, I don't even know. It'd be insane. Compared to other things, fluorescent, CFLs, stuff like that, it's actually about the same. Maybe a little bit more efficient. Sodium, mercury, mercury vapor, gas discharge style, again, about the same. It really depends on your application, and depends on the quality of the electronics in your LEDs. The cool thing about LEDs is not only are they more efficient than those other options, but the ones where they're kind of in line with the efficiency of like the gas discharge and the fluorescence, they are way better in other ways. So they're just as efficient as them, but better in every other aspect. Moving on. Why do LEDs last so long? That's a good question. I really like that question. In our experience, we find that things that move don't last as long as things that don't move. When you're heating up an incandescent bulb, it's getting hot and getting cool, hot, cool, hot, cool, hot, cool, every time you turn on and off the switch. And that's one of the reasons why you don't want to flick an incandescent light bulb. And each time it does that, it's going until it finally cracks. And once that tungsten filament cracks, well, it's completely useless. Now, a semiconductor, it's literally just two pieces of material sitting next to each other. You're running some electrons through it. And there's no moving parts. Nothing's getting that hot in the junction itself. Now, the electronics that power it sometimes, those will get hot and those will break down. And so that's one really cool thing that you can tell. What failed, the LED or the electronics? Did it get dimmer and dimmer and dimmer and go out? Then it's typically the LED. Did it just go out or is it flickering, stuff like that? That's actually the electronics that are running the LED that went out. So that's one good way to tell the difference. LEDs are doing better than all those other ones simply because they run cooler, they don't generate heat. If they were perfectly efficient, nothing would be hot at all. It would all be straight photons coming out. But in reality, it's not perfect still, even though they're much, much better. So sometimes when those electrons drop, instead of emitting a photon, they'll generate heat. But they do it much, much less than most of the other sources. And so that's why they last so much longer. Are LEDs AC or DC? Excellent question. Part of the confusion there is because you take those light bulbs that look like the old school incandescents and you put them into an AC socket and they produce light. And so you're like, oh, sweet, they're AC. Nope. Again, those bulbs in the bottom, they have electronics that's converting that AC to DC. Now, in reality, they can run on AC. But again, electricity can only go one way in a diode, not both ways. And with AC, it goes one way, then another way, one way, then another way. And so if you don't have something in there and you just take an LED and hook it straight up to an AC signal, it'll give you light and then it won't give you light in the negative. Give you light and then it won't give you light. So you can easily put a bridge rectifier in there to make it so you get light, get light, get light. But even then you notice how that's not, you get good light, you get brighter, dimmer, brighter, dimmer. Of course, that's cycling at 60 or 120 hertz a second if you take that bottom portion and flip it over to the top. So it's happening too fast for us to really see, but that's not the most efficient way in terms of actually driving it. But at the same time, it's super cheap. It's better than getting some sort of rectifier in there that's taking this signal and making it a beautiful, crisp DC signal. So LEDs are DC, but they can run on AC, just not as well. And they can hook straight into your AC because almost every LED out there has the electronics that makes it so it runs on the AC. Next question. What are LEDs made from? Okay, that is wide. So they're made of different materials. And I, again, going back to that thing of how far you want the electron to drop for the amount of energy that it drops, you need different materials. Now, gallium arsenide pops into my mind. I think that's red, or no, is that blue? Dude, I don't memorize this stuff. But it's a variety of semiconductor materials, and maybe that's what I should focus on. Semiconductor materials are materials that sometimes conduct, like a conductor, and sometimes they don't conduct, like an insulator. And the way that you change that is by doping them and throwing some impurities in there that sometimes make them a little bit more conductive or a little bit less conductive. And then as you change the voltage across them, you'll make them go from a state of not wanting to conduct to a state of wanting to conduct. Now, the way you get really cool things out of semiconductors is you take those semiconductors of different types and you put them together. And the way they act at that junction really changes them. You can get all sorts of cool stuff besides LEDs by that junction. So semiconductors are two materials, you put them together, and then they behave in such a way that when the electron goes across, it drops an energy, releases that energy as a photon. Moving on. Are LEDs polarized? Polarized, yes. I'm just thinking the North Pole, no. Polarized, does it matter which way that you put it in? Definitely, definitely it matters a lot. Thank you, Taylor. LEDs, you can actually see that there is one leg that is slightly longer. Oh, this is kind of weird. Maybe this one's been trimmed a bit. And then if you look inside, which you probably can't see, you notice that on one side it's this tiny little stick coming up, and then there's this other side that has this big cup. And that big cup is the negative side, the cathode, I believe, and then the small thingy is the anode. And if you hook this up backwards, it's just not going to do anything. Now, if you hook it up backwards and put a huge amount of voltage over it, you get to blow it up, and it's kind of fun because it'll overheat right there, and then the plastic will go pop. But that's actually surprisingly hard to do. It only seems to happen when you don't want it to. But yes, LEDs are polarized because they are diodes, so it very much matters which side is positive and which side is negative, because it will not work if you put it in backwards. Moving on. Will 24-volt LEDs work on 12 volts? No. LEDs, they don't conduct at all until you reach their forward voltage, until you hit a certain point that you have enough energy to overcome the barrier between the two portions, the two materials that are touching each other. So if you have a 24-volt LED, it's designed to wait until it has 24 volts before it crosses that barrier and goes up. Now, mostly when you see these 24 versus 12-volt LEDs, you're talking about the strings of LEDs, and they're usually, what they do is they divide those strings up so you have like, hey, I'm gonna have six LEDs be in series at a time, and then six LEDs times 1.7 is about 10 volts or something like that. And then they say, hey, actually I wanna make this a 24-volt string. Okay, then they do 12 LEDs in series. The overall voltage drop across all 12 of those, again, will equal around 20-ish volts. So if you take a 12-volt LED string and put 24 volts across it, it will work, and you might not even destroy it. You will in the long term, but if you put 12 volts across a 24-volt rated LED string, it's just not going to do anything. You're not going to harm it. Nothing's going to happen. But if you flip it and have 24 volts over 12 volts, yeah, you're at best going to shorten the length of time that that string is going to work. At worst, going to have some fireworks or just fires. So, moving on. How do LEDs change color? Myth. They do not change color. LEDs are actually completely incapable of changing color. Their color is defined by the materials that are involved. Once those LEDs are manufactured, they produce that color. That's all they can do. Wait, you say, Josh, that doesn't make any sense. I've seen RGB LEDs that change their color. Ha, they don't. So in an RGB LED, they actually have three LEDs in there acting at the same time. You have a red, green, and a blue, and as you control them and make one brighter and one not so bright, dimmer, that's the word I was going for, and change that ratio between them, they create different colors. But in reality, all you're doing is adding or subtracting those colors to get exactly what you want. There isn't an actual change of the color of the LED. So once we get past that, the way you do change LED colors is by making your red or your green or your blue brighter or dimmer to get the necessary color that you want. The actual LEDs themselves do not ever change color. Though they do get a little bit warmer sometimes, depending on how much electricity you go. Oh man, don't make me back up on this. No, they do not change color. Nope, I'm sticking with it.